What is the field engineer job description? I get asked this all the time, and I'm going to go through the exact duties and responsibilities of a field engineer so you know what the job description should be. At the end of this video, I'm going to turn this into a blog post and a checklist that you can use if you're hiring. But really what I want to say, and I hope you're interested in this, is that if companies, construction companies, would get back to field engineering, not only would they train an awesome new set of superintendents for the future, but they would get back to builder basics and everything will run better on every single project. So if you're into that, please stay with us on this video. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. I love this numero uno, layout and surveying. Now I know what you're thinking, Jason, that only applies when we're doing self-perform and hey, I'm not gonna be a surveyor, I don't need to do it. Wrong. The way we act in the first part of our career or the things we do program our minds to literally become the builder that we wanna be. When you're doing level loops and differential leveling, your brain starts to imagine elevations from the mean sea level and for you to understand how elevations work in the real world. The second thing is when you're using a total station, when you're chaining distances, when you're learning coordinate geometry, you literally start to think in Y, X, Z, and you think in this spatial, I would say, context. And you really start to understand how buildings are put together and the importance of location, the X, Y, and Z. And then when you become a superintendent and you're worried about time, X, Y, Z, T, now you have a four-dimensional builder perspective. Think of like control is where you have survey points for primary control, secondary control around the building, and then working control around the component. That control guides the layout of every other component on site. That is a key responsibility of a field engineer, and we cannot ignore it or get rid of it. Number two, quality control verification. Why in the world did we even do the primary, secondary, and working control? I'll tell you, because we are QCing the wall location, the elevation, the embeds, the sleeve locations, how far the dowels poke out, the plumb of the walls and the columns. Like, we are using all of this to QC in the field. That's very, very important, and it's a main duty of a field engineer. The third one is to create lift drawings and to obviously write RFIs and find problems. Now, let me say this real quick. What is a lift drawing? Let's say that you have your architectural drawings, your structural, mechanical. Let's say you have lab equipment drawings, you know, all kinds of drawings everywhere, shop drawings. A lift drawing pulls the pertinent information into one location. Oh my gosh, this is so good. For one piece of work, so you can work in one piece flow, plan it, build it, finish it. And it pulls all that information together in coordination for these purposes in this order. Let me tell you this. Number one, so you, the builder, can learn the building. Number two, so you, the builder, can find and fix problems, especially with RFIs, before they impact the work. And then three, to create a coordination drawing for the field. Lift drawings tie into item two, which is QC. How are you going to know what distance to measure to check that embed? How are you going to know the sleeve location? How are you going to know how far that those dowels should be sticking out the side of the wall if you don't have a lift drawing there to help you? Lift drawings are key to the role of field engineering. Number four, we help coordinate the preparation of trade work, meaning for the trade crews out in the field. And I want you to look at it not like they're separate components, but that control, layout, lift drawings literally enable the trade. Like if you think about it, the trade partner needs the tools, equipment, materials, the information, right? And the layout. So the information and the layout, those last two come with a field engineer or from a field engineer, having lift drawings and having the layout. You're preparing and enabling the work of the craft. Number five, and I love this one, you're solving field issues. Let me start with something first. I've done projects as a field engineer and as a superintendent with field engineers, and then I've done a project without field engineers. Oh my goodness, if I could cuss on this video, I would do it right now. I hated the experience without field engineers. Supers have to do all the double checking, all of the follow-up, all of the paperwork. They don't have any help. There's no runners. In the book, Building the Empire State, they talked about how the project superintendent had runners that would like literally communicate information. There's more mistakes. You're literally eating money out of contingency. You're dealing with embed problems, lots of RFIs. You're making the owner mad. I even heard from a client one time, a really high-profile client that says, I really like this contractor that you're working for. for, Jason, but you can really tell the difference between a company with and without field engineers. If you don't have field engineers, the quality's not there, the follow-up's not there, right? So I absolutely do not love ever being without field engineers, and actually I will never do it again. And so this is the story that I want to tell you. One time when we did have field engineers and I was supervising an area, having a great time of it, I remember one of the assistant supers on the project site was leaning into that non-field engineer mode, right? Really distracted with doing RFIs, really distracted running around. And I was like, hey, I won't say his name, but I love you. You're doing great, but you're distracted with the field engineering. I need you to be planning and preparing work, allocating labor, making sure materials are on time, organizing the trade partners, right? If it is an RFI or a detail question, or this is about layout, we want the field engineers to be fielding those questions. Let's have the FEs and the PEs fielding those questions. And for the most part, the individual trade should handle their own work. They should be researching. They should be writing their own RFIs. They should be doing this work, right? And so solving problems in the field not only helps the trades, it's not only a main skill for a field engineer, it not only helps the entire project, but it creates capacity for the superintendents. Number six, assist with inspections. And this is great. When I think about the argument that, you know, hey, we don't need field engineers because we don't do self-perform, you still need field engineers, you still need primary control, you still need secondary control, you still need working control, you still need lift drawings, whether you're doing the concrete or the masonry or not, you still need to double check the work out in the field, you still need to work with the foreman, but let's add on inspections. Field engineers, even if they didn't do all this stuff over here, still need to be doing concrete pre-placement inspections, in-wall inspections, overhead ceiling inspections, then, and God forbid you have a massive punch list, but be helping with incomplete work list and punch list, and then the overall commissioning of the building. They really help with QC. Field engineers should be the ones really bird-dogging the in-wall and overhead inspections, and with the superintendent, the pre-placement inspections. And I will say on this note here, if you're a super having trouble with mistakes in concrete, you've got to get out there and teach those field engineers how to QC a concrete placement. Okay. So let's go into number seven, pre-construction planning. Back in my days, Hensel Phelps, which I love that experience, field engineers would be there before the project started. Not only in pre-construction would they be doing the primary control based off of the basis of bearings, they'd be establishing secondary, they would be establishing the primary control plan, they would be preparing for lift drawings, and they would be helping to get trades ready for their first scopes out, especially concrete. So field engineers, as a part of their role, will be a part of pre-construction. Number eight, tracking material deliveries and placement. This is huge. I always believe that if you can get the materials to the project site, which field engineers can help with and help track, then when we receive those, they've got to go to the right location. So hopefully you have daily foreman huddles where the foremen are saying this goes there, and it's a coordinated collaborative effort. Field engineers can help make sure that those deliveries with the project engineers are inspected from a material inspection standpoint and that they end up in the right place so we don't have to move them multiple times. And then number nine, safety and safety planning. This is huge. Now they aren't like as proficient as the superintendents, but they can help with safety. I look at field engineers as the frontline quality and safety leaders, or I would say probably managers, or it's the first line of defense. I learned more about quality and safety as a field engineer than I ever did anywhere else because you're practicing in being a builder. So doing the inspections, if your company has like some form of doing observations in your software platform, field engineers do that, talking to people, noticing, being a safety presence in the field. It's absolutely huge. And then the last thing, you're gonna be doing reports and charts, daily reports, written documentation, right? Whether that's handwriting or on the computer. One quick side note because I'm petty. Please start writing in block lettering with all caps. It just does not work to be a communicator and to have horrible handwriting. Anyway, quick sidebar there, I don't want to derail us. But these are the roles and responsibilities. These are the duties of a field engineer, and it's specifically the job description. So what I'm going to do, like I said, is put this into a little blog post. Hopefully you love it. If you do, please like the video. And then also give you a little job description as well in the description below. Reach out to us if you ever have difficulty, and always check out the book, Construction Surveying and Layout, otherwise known as the Field Engineering Methods Manual, for more. If you really want to do well, you'll have field engineers doing the right things in your company. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.